What's up, everybody? It's Zach from Switch Force, and we are here with a game that I've been waiting for quite some time. Yono and the Celestial Elephants is a puzzle action game in the style of Legend of Zelda, if Link had a gigantic trunk that was his favorite friend. This trunk can do so many things, and we're about to showcase them early. The game hits this week on Thursday, $14.99, but Neckbolt was kind enough to send us a review code to check out with you. So I am going to drop in and see what it's all about. It's got a very clever and cool look, and I like the idea of a magical sky elephant helping us from the heavens solve puzzles, accomplish tasks, and move through this magical, magical world. So let's see what it's all about and see if it lives up to the hype. There's our baby boy, ready for action. Sent from the stars above, Yono is ready for action. Playing with a Joy-Con, by the way. And here is Yono and Sundara. Hi, I'm Sundara. I saw you fall from the sky. What kind of thing are you?
Well met, Sundara. My name is Yono. I'm an elephant.
I'm a human. Nice to meet you. I'm on the lookout for an adventure, which is why I'm out here in the wilderness. Then I saw this big, shiny star fall from the sky, and I figured that could be a good place to look. That's how I found you so quick.
That's what I'm here for, too. I am ready for an adventure.
There's a small village just up ahead. It's called Windhill. That's where I was when I saw the star. Come on, I'll take you there. Follow me. All right, so girl with a lot of adventure in her hair and an elephant who fell from the sky above are about to become best friends and quest together. All right, Oma's Peninsula. I've got Headbutt. I've got my trunk. Ooh, wow. Dude, that's a powerful trunk. I can feel that one shaking my actual skin. I can target lock, too. That's interesting. You have to hold it. Oh, so it, like, puts you in place. So you... Uh-huh. Headbutt the turtle.
Poor turtle!
All right, what does this sign say? Secret forest jar shrine. Please don't lift my jars. Please don't stand in front of them and press your interact button. They break easily. All right, let's try this out. Oh my god, yes. Look at that guy. He's got some good elephant moves, and you can already see sort of the old school Zelda inspiration and styling. And it's $14.99, so that's a pretty good price. We'll have to see, you know, like, if it can be at least pretty decent. I think $14.99 is, like I said, like, that could be a good value, so we'll have to see. These big boulders are blocking the path. I just jumped over them before, but maybe you'll want to find another solution. No offense. I wager even rocks like these are no match for that mighty skull of yours. I'll see you down the road. Try and keep up. Whoa. Nice jump there. Alright, so two headbutts and we get through. Yono's a little bit slow on the move. I did try to play with the Pro Controller, and I don't know if it's just my Pro Controller is freaking out, but my Pro Controller seemed to work with ARMS and some other games I played this morning. Doesn't seem like Yono uses Pro Controller, so I'm using Split Joy-Con right now, and it's fine. It seems to be a simple control scheme, but I just wanted to point that out. Wow, you really pulverized those boulders. How strong are you? I bet you can push this big, heavy box around like it was nothing. Just keep walking right into it for a while, until it starts moving. Really, put your back into it, you know? Personally, I can't even budge it. Well, I'll run ahead. Don't dawdle. Her bouncing is a little bit freaky. I'm not sure that a human being is supposed to bounce like that. All right. Okay, so it shifts like one block at a time. Mm-hmm, and that's our path forward. Oh, look, some nice animation on these little clovers. Little three leafers. Any four leafers in there? Down we go. Look at all these dandelions. Don't you just want to blow them all out? Kaploofy! And I mean, your nose is huge. Just imagine what a mighty gust you can whip up with that thing. Hey, don't talk about my nose like that. Your hair is huge, Sundara. And also your tooth gap is huge. Anyway, we're not far from Windhill now. Just a bit more. I'll meet you again when we get there. So long! And again with the freaking clown bounce. All right. Okay, oh, look, we get some, like, currency out of this. That's kind of cool. Health and currency. So health is red. Currency is, like, the gold bronze pieces. All right. Let's go. Oh, God, a tightrope? Ooh, cool. Okay, so as you can see, the puzzle-solving elements are starting to take shape. And I hope it gets pretty complicated. I think there's something like 3 dungeons in this game. It's a pretty, like, small number, but we'll have to see how expansive they are, how they really feel, and all that stuff. I mean, it is a $15 game, so keep that in mind. But we'll have to see how it feels in the content side of things. Alright, looks like we're gonna push this. Headbutt is also like a dash, kind of. Headbutt does not work to move objects, so you just have to walk into them. Interesting, okay. And headbutt cannot break all rocks, only ones that are asking to be broken. Aha, so we gust that, and now we've created a moving platform. Nice, nice, and a chest! Headbutt the chest? Interact with the chest. There we go, ooh. You found a health token! Collect 4 and take them to your nearest health token exchange service to trade them in for an extra health container. Alright, so yes. Zelda, right? You get that vibe. It's kind of cool, though. People have been, like, wanting a 2D Zelda on Switch. So if this can do that, like, that's a huge, huge get. For not only the game, but for the system. Hey, girl. Yeah, you made it all the way. I knew you would. Windhill is right here. It's just a small village, nowhere near the size of Nightingale City, where I'm from. It's a cute place, though, and it's quite peaceful and remote. Just the thing if you find that you need to disappear for a little while. I'll make my way back to Nightingale City eventually, but for now, I'm loafing around in these parts of the world. By the way, don't be shy in talking to people. That's really the best way to learn more about what's going on. And don't hesitate to talk to the same person several times, either. I find that most people just love the sound of their own voices, and almost everyone has many interesting things to say if you just prod them a little. I myself have been bothering every stranger I've met all the way from Nightingale City. Alright, where's the boing boing? I want to see that bounce. No bouncing. Alright. This way to Windhill, a small village with a big wind obsession. Sounds perfect for my trunk. I do know that eventually you can get elemental upgrades for your trunk, so that'll be sick. In the meantime, though, welcome to Windhill. Windhill! Something is scribbled beneath the name. Ingrid was here. Uh-oh, who's Ingrid? Whoa, weird art style. Kind of cool.
Good day.
Oh, hello there, little one. You startled me. Pray tell, what exactly are you, some sort of animal? I'm terribly sorry to ask if it's rude, I mean. It's just, you may very well be the first four-legged creature I've ever talked with.
It's quite all right, ma'am. I am an elephant.
An elephant, you say? How curious. I've never even heard of elephants before.
I have come here to help the people and do my best to bring joy to the world.
Well, that sounds positively splendid. Welcome to Windhill, little elephant. Our village is not big, but it's quite charming, wouldn't you say? I think you can make many new friends here if you just take a look around.
All right, cool, cool. All right, let's see. What is this thing gonna do here? Uh-huh. Can we drop down on this? Whoop! Ooh. A secret cave of wonders? Or at least of jars. Okay, so you can also headbutt jars. I like that. That's good to know. Jar butt. There we go. Windhill's Candy Pirate Club. No grown-ups allowed. If you get past our obstacles, you will find our treasure. Interesting. Okay, Candy Pirate Club. All right, so we gotta be careful not to lock ourselves in here. Oh, jeez. There we go. Make way for the king. The king of the elephants. Alright, so that's like the easiest way is to throw. But I actually think headbutting might be quicker. You know? Alright, so that was that all the obstacles? Oh no, there's more. Okay. I was gonna say, please tell me that's all the obstacles. This is the start of the game. So you are gonna get just like a baseline sense of what's going on here. But I am curious, like, if there's eventually bosses, how complex things get. Whoa, nice, okay. So we can knock things off the shelf, that's kind of cool. Good little physics-y enhancement there. Which way, USA? Let's go here. Oh, we're up in some shop, clearly. So I'm not going to drop down just because it seems like that's in a shop and probably can access that lower floor from somewhere else. So let's try... Wait, do these respawn their... Oh, they do, they respawn their currency. That's weird. Normally stuff, like, I could get the jars respawning, but respawning the currency? Interesting, huh? So you just farm currency in there. Alright. Boulder, boulder. Big old boulder. Alright, push that down. And then we're gonna take it around. Little elephant. It's kind of cool to be an elephant just because it's a character that... Not really that explored in video games, right? I mean, he's a little slow, a little plodding, but just his moveset is pretty interesting. All right. Whoa. Cool, cool. Heading deeper and deeper into this cave of Pirate Candy Club-ness. up to 71 on the trinket count. I do wish these loads were a little more instantaneous. But there's their treasure, so we have made it through, which is good. And inside we've got another health token! Woo! Alright, so is there an easy way through, or do we... I guess we can just drop down back into that shop. That's probably our best bet, right? So you can again just bust this and get all the goodies. Alright. But let's head back to that shop, drop down, and get a little bit more time in the village. That's kind of what we're here for mainly anyways. I just figured, let's see what a little like puzzle quest is like. Alright. Yeah, you can't break any of the big barrels, but you can break the little guys over and over and over again.
Whoa.
Hey! Lalsa says, the old man who lives down over there is so scary. He's the village undertaker and he's a zombie.
A zombie? What do you mean?
I mean, he's not alive. He's no less a corpse than those he has undertaken to undertake. He's wearing a long black cloak. His hands are cold as the breath of death, and his face is as white as bone. He gives me the heebie-jeebies.
What are you doing here by his house, then?
I want to get a good look at him, of course. This is so exciting. Wait, didn't you just say you were, like, terrifying? Chicken. Oh, yes. I've got animal friends, and I'm moving them around.
Good day. I'm a traveling marble merchant. I sell marbles.
That's very nice. How is business going?
Not good at all. I put down the merchandise for a short while, and now I can't for the life of me remember where I put it.
Have you lost your marbles?
Yes, I have. I can't find them anywhere.
I'll help you look.
You will?
Yes, I'm an elephant. I'm here to bring peace and harmony and to help anyone in need. I will find your marbles for you.
Thank you very much.
Alright, now we're on a marble mission. What is this guy? Hey!
Ahoy there, Yono. Look at this sleeping boy I found. Can we keep him?
Judging from his clothes and shaved head, I wager he's a monk from the temple in the city. Though he can hardly be more than a novice. And that makes me wonder what he's doing all the way out here. Or perhaps, what he should be doing, instead of dozing off. Wouldn't it be hilarious to wake him up in a really startling fashion? Maybe I should yell really- No! Let's splash a bucket- No! That would certainly be a riot laugh- a right laugh?
Don't you think it'll be upset?
Good idea, Yono. Way to be her conscience. Look at it this way, he's most likely here in Windhill for a reason. Some pilgrimage or mission or something. And if that is the case, he probably shouldn't be sleeping like this in the first place. In fact, I bet he'll be thankful if you wake him up. Oh gosh. Hey. I'm headbutting him. Doesn't work. So we got- okay. Getting a bunch of mini-quests is very Zelda-like. Well, a little slower.
Manjo says, Hurry up, Raph, what to do?
Oh, what are you?
I am an elephant, I've come to-
Yeah, we know. You're a very helpful elephant.
Why, that is certainly grand, for I am indeed in need. Do you see my crops over there? I just can't get them to grow.
Why not? What do they need?
Beats me. Maybe they just need some water. It's been rather dry as of late. Maybe you can find a tub of water somewhere and fill up that prolonged proboscis of yours.
That certainly sounds like a job for me. I'm on it.
Alright, so... clearly this is going to gain us some water abilities with our nose. Wow. Alright, not a whole lot going on in here. Just gotta find some wawa. Water me- okay, there's some water. Good. What is this? Oh, this is the guy's marbles. Okay, so the water and the marbles literally in the same spot. Not a very tricky puzzle.
Oh, look, you found my lost marbles. Fantastic. Now I can go right back to business. How can I ever repay you?
Not necessary at all. I'm happy to help.
You deserve a reward. I'll give you 300. Oh my god, 300?
Please keep your money. I'm as an elephant. I'm just here to help. I don't want anything in return. I'm just doing what I am here to do.
Really? Elephants are truly magical. It's nice to have one walk the earth again. It's been ages since the last time there was an elephant. You know what I will do? I will travel to Nightingale City and donate the coins to the monks of the temple instead.
That sounds like a very good idea.
Fantastic. Thanks again, Mr. Elephant, for all your help. I'm so happy you're here. Just wait until the people in the capital city hears about your arrival. Alright, bye, Marble Boy.
Almost got 300 coins. And then Yono was too good of a sport. Alright, let's suck up this water. Oh, dang. Alright. My nose is a little bit pudgy. You can see on the bottom right, I got that water element as I accidentally walk into this house. And then walk right back out. Please don't take my water away. I hope not. Can I keep my water? Great. Okay, so note to self, also annoying game design. You lose your element or your held liquid. When you enter a building. Okay, there we go. That was kind of cool. May the flowers go. I think he needs a little more water. Let's get some more for these plants. The trunk mechanic is probably the thing I think will end up being the coolest in the game, especially if they utilize it like in dungeons or if the puzzle solving really like, you know, gets a little more complex. All right, let's see. How you feel now? You did it. You made all my plants grow. That was certainly the most glorious display of nose action I've ever seen. At least since my grandma sneezed that one time. All right. Do I get any? No, I guess maybe these aren't really rewards. They're kind of just teaching us, you know? I mean, okay. Lessons are okay. They're not as exciting as rewards, but... What's this train place? Oh! Did you know that the Makani built a whole network of subterranean railways all over the kingdom? One day I'm going to ride a train all the way to Nightingale City, but I'm too small to ride that far. Can the railroads take you anywhere? Yes, all the major cities and a lot of other places as well. But you'll have to visit the cities first by yourself before you can take a train there. That's why I'm not allowed to ride yet. In the meantime, I wear my trusty adventure helmet. Alright, so basically eventually we're going to get the ability to fast travel via trains. In the meantime, we got to navigate and find the cities ourselves. What do you think these, like, colored... You'll see in a second. Like, these kind of, like, xylophone-y looking things? I wonder what that's all about. Is this a robot? Hello, robot.
Good day, sir. My, aren't you a strange creature? If you don't mind me asking, what exactly are you?
I am an elephant. My name is Yono. You're a pretty strange one yourself.
Oh, not at all, sir. I am a Makani. I come from the robotic city-state of Freehaven. If you are wondering what I am doing down here in Windhill, sir, the answer is that I am on vacation.
Cool. A vacationing robot, and clearly a hint of what's to come. Oh my gosh. This is an exchange guy.
Welcome, adventurer. This is your health token exchange service. How can I help you?
Token exchange?
Indeed, this is the place to trade your... Yep. Alright.
Collect 4, come back. Nice. Bring them. Blah. We've got 2, so we're halfway there. But can't really do any dancing with that bot as of yet. Have we spoken to her? Oh yeah, okay. Spying on the Undertaker. Let's go in here. Is the Undertaker in here? Ah!
Hello, stranger. You are new to these lands.
Yes, yes, I am. In fact, I just landed.
I have never seen an elephant before. They say it's an omen of good things to come for both the living and the dead. I am one of the Bone Whites. We are the walking remains of the long time dead, eternally enjoying the beauty of this world.
I've never met a dead person before. How come you do not lie buried in the ground yourself?
It is because of the Sunder Garden. Hundreds of years ago, a huge battle took place in the fields that are now called the Sunder Garden. The two armies were the largest the world had ever seen, and so equal in strength that not one of them could defeat the other. The bloodbath lasted for days, until not a single warrior was left standing. There was no victor. But the dead bodies of the warriors sank into the earth like seeds, and these ancient cadavers are now sprouting Bone Whites like me. We spring from the ground like flowers and exist in this world without aging or dying. The Sunder Garden is our home.
Sounds like a place of wonder.
The Sacred Cemetery is the most beautiful place on Earth.
Alright. I love how Yona's like, yo, it sounds awesome. Just a bunch of dead bodies soaking into the ground and turning into zombies. That's pretty cool. Always the optimist. Alright, so... Did we go in here? I'm not sure. Oh, wow, what is this? The professor, help me. My scientific experiments seem to attract a whole lot of Snokes. They've invaded my cellar and I can't go down there anymore.
Maybe I could help you clear them out.
Oh, could you? They are nasty little creatures, but they are not very dangerous if one is careful. If you find any treasure down the cellar, you can keep it as a reward for me with a Snoke problem.
Like Emperor Snoke?
Maybe we'll get another, another heart container. Or another shard.
I could study this map for hours. Windhill, Nightingale City, the Sunder Garden, and Freehaven, it's all there.
There should be a map like this in every town. We just received one here in Windhill. Oh. There we are in Windhill, Hedgehog Forest, Nightingale, Freehaven, Acorn, Troll Moss. Cool, cool. Let's go help with this Snoke problem, though. And this, I like how you just, like, bounce up on stuff. It's kind of funny. Down we go. Oh! So, we just headbutt these guys over and over again? Some of the sound effects are a little weird. Although, I like the look of these snakes quite a bit. Definitely a very easy start to the game. And I'll have to play a while longer to see if it evolves. But as of now, like, it's very charming. And I like the aesthetic they have going on. I wish it was a bit more challenging, and it didn't have this, like, same slow plotting start that we come to expect. Unless this is just the whole game. Like, it is going to be a more slow, kind of explore the towns, solve a few little puzzles type adventure. It could very well be that. Or maybe it's going to dramatically increase in pace and tone once we sort of complete. These are definitely tutorial areas. You can tell just based on the fact, like, hey, learn how to pick up water. Learn how to pick up jars. Learn how to look for... what do you call it? Health stations, you know? There's also a chest here. Alright, so I have 4, so we'll go wake this dude up, and then we can go grab another heart. We'll have 5, although I haven't been touched yet, so... No clue if combat gets more difficult. It's gotta be pretty slow-paced combat, just based on what you can do, right? What Yono is able to do. Oh!
Ah! What's going on? I'm awake!
Hello there, sleepyhead. My name is Sundara, and this is my friend Yono. He's an elephant.
Hi, Sundara. I'm pleased to meet you. My name is Kai, wait, did you say elephant? Ivory above, you really are an elephant. You have the trunk and the ears and everything. I can't believe my eyes!
Believe it, Buster. He looks just like that big statue in the town square.
Then it is true, all of it. That means these are blessed times indeed.
I'm glad my presence means so much to you, but I wouldn't exactly say...
It means everything. Most people nowadays regard elephants as creatures of myth, if they know of you at all. There have been over 1,000 years since this world was last visited by an elephant.
That's a lot of years.
And the memories from those times have transformed to fancy legends and fairy tales. The temple in Nightingale City is trying to keep the old traditions alive, but we are only a handful of monks nowadays.
And desperate enough to initiate just about anyone, it seems. Ha ha ha.
Sundara, that wasn't a very nice thing to say.
It's true, though. I was sent here to Windhill on a mission, though what that mission is was never really specified. I suspect they just wanted me out of the temple for a while after the incident with the tapestry and the soup, and the cat, and the ancient vase.
Oh man, I wish I could have seen that.
But I'm glad I'm here now and get to see Yono the Elephant in my own eyes. I must guide you back to Nightingale City. How surprised the other monks will be when I, the Lost Hope, turn back together with the next elephant.
I'm from Nightingale City as well, and that's where all the real action is. Now that Yono's here, we should totally spread the good news all the people of the kingdom.
Okay.
We'll head north from here, through Hedgehog Forest.
Come on, let's go already. Oh gosh. Clumsy monk. Can't even keep himself a foot on the bridge. But we'll follow ahead anyways. And see where this takes us. Hedgehog Forest, what up? You better watch out. You know, there are a couple of Rob Goblins down the valley, and they seem to block the path of fire.
Rob Goblins? What are they?
Predatory and aggressive little scavengers. Because of their weapons and armor, they look a bit like people, but they're really not. They're just attracted to metals and will carry around anything they can find, steal or plunder. They are just like what my mom says our lives would be like without a structured society. Nasty, brutish, and short. Right, because without structure, they're going to be short.
Ever since I can remember, I've always wanted to believe in the stories. That's why I became a monk in the first place, to learn more about the mystical elephants who came to our world and lay under us to our balance and harmony and realm of chaos. And now you are here, which confirms my beliefs and brings a purpose to my whole life. I was so lost. I'm terribly sorry for the state of the world, Yono. There are Rob Goblins all over the place. It's a real hassle to travel between cities. I'm afraid you'll have to see a fight or two before we reach our journey's end.
I'll certainly do my best.
I have faith in you, well, obviously, but you know what I mean.
Alright, this a Rob Goblin? That's a little hedge boy. Poor little hedgehog. What do these guys do? Ah, gosh! So it's literally just headbutting his combat. I hope eventually our trunk gets an ability or something. Alright, now obviously we gotta go and find some water. Load up on the blue liquid. And then take our talents back to the fire. And put it out. Cool. Through we go. Hedgehog Forest. There's a lot of hedgehogs in Hedgehog Forest, as you can see. Alright, what's this saying? By the Queen's orders, Hedgehog Tunnel has been filled with traps. This is an attempt to keep the Rob Goblins out. Please proceed with caution. Alright. Ow. Pretty easy. Also, we only lose a third of our health, or... I guess, oh, we lose 2 chunks. So, you have, in effect, 16 health pips. Now, I did not buy a new health chunk when I was back in Windfall, Windhill. But I'm sure there's one we can get in the next city as well. And also, these guys are going to drop all of them. And literally just headbutt everybody. Combat seems like kind of an afterthought. Oh, what's that? It's a key. I think the best thing this game has going for it is the whole elephant, like, charm that it's got going on. And it has, like, a pretty cool aesthetic. Alright. Yeah, these guys are a cinch to fight. Well, also because we recover health so darn easy. Alright, back on that water grind. More fires. Alright, I guess we don't need the water yet, but there we go. Well, I'm not quite sure what that does. Oh, okay. I know what we gotta do. We have to absolutely get this little crate on there. Oh, okay. Here we go. Now then, we can go bring this crate up and utilize it to hit that switch. Cool, cool. Push it off before it falls. Good work, Yono. Alright. And kaboom. Alright, now we've got that moving piece. And it looks like there's fire over there, so I am going to go load up on a little liquid. You can see that it is getting a little bit more complex. I wish Yono was a little faster. A little slow on the crawl here, you know? Alright. Take me a... Seriously? Oh, yes. Oh, this is just a chest. But it's the key that we need. So it was a very valuable and worthwhile action. Alright. Now we'll take the key here. Okay, so the puzzles are getting a little more detailed. At least requiring multiple steps. So maybe they will enhance significantly as time goes on. Passing through Hedgehog Tunnel. Getting some tokens and trinkets. And taking our talents, hopefully, to Nightingale. A little slow down there. Interesting, just a note on the performance side. The cable ref system is out of order during low tide. Sorry for the inconvenience. Huh. Hey, hey. Enough movement to make it across. So yeah, eventually if we get more and more different options for our trunk, it could be pretty cool. All right, water puts the fire out and water also puts this wheel on notice. So let's fill that wheel. I kind of, like, in my head, Yono was a little bit faster paced, so I kind of wish it was a little bit of a faster paced game. You know, I appreciate and respect a slower paced game, and I get what they're going for, but I kind of think that the game would be better served if it did move a little quicker and play a little quicker. I think that would be in its best interest. But given what it is, like, I think it's a cute, charming little title. I don't know how much, you know, like I said, how expansive it is, how varied it is. That's something you need to play, like, probably the whole game to really figure out. But as of now, like, I think it's, if it looks like your thing, I think it's solid. I don't have, like, a ringing endorsement for it, just because I do wish it played a little quicker, and I wish it was a little more, I don't know, like, puzzle roomy instead of just, like, villagey, you know what I mean? Like, that, it was a little bit, almost more challenging, a little more challenge-based, something of that sort, rather than, it's more of, like, a very traditional, adventure, and I think some people are gonna love that, and like I said, people have been jonesing for like a 2D Zelda for a while, so there's definitely something to say for a game like this having a home on Switch and being like a unique, cool experience. And if, you know, if for $15 you get a couple good hours of gameplay, it might be totally worth it to you. But it does play a little slower than I expected. And I do kind of wish that it was more challenge-based and room-based and almost like, I don't know if strategy is the right word, but yeah. Because if he's not going to move fast, then action, as you can see, the combat isn't really the focus. It's much more about the puzzles. And like some stuff, like that's not even really a puzzle. That's just like, go get the key. But maybe, we'll give it the benefit of the doubt. Maybe once we get more trunk abilities, I don't know if you can mix and mash them. It's not really abilities. It's kind of more like sucking up. So I'm guessing we're going to do this similar thing, like somehow like get electricity in our trunk, although that sounds very painful. Pull a switch and a treasure appears? A little easy, huh? Well, we made it through that room. And just, again, the combat is literally just headbutting over and over. I don't know. Alright, we got multiple windows here, but we're gonna need to push this block this way. The risk of dying seems incredibly low, you know? Hey, another block! Alright. Really? What was the timer on? Oh, weird, okay. Yeah, a lot of headbutting. I'm not too certain that this is going to change up much. I have a feeling this is kind of the main MO of the game, with maybe a little more complexity as you go. Like, this one's kind of cool. Okay, so move the block here to access the water over there. But it does have a simplicity to it that you may like, you may not. I guess it just depends on the player you know, the kind of player you are and what you're looking for. Alright, I think I have to go up there to access that, I think. Hey buddy, let me headbutt you. And also let me move back into this room now. Alright, because now I'm up here. I can get this. Whole lot of coinage. Alright. So, we'll head back into this room. Sounds like the door is gonna shut before we get there. But then what's odd is if you do that, it just automatically makes the block appear back on the switch. Which is interesting. It is also kind of weird that the room is reset, so there's never going to be multi-room puzzles. They're all going to be accomplished within this specific room, you know? Although this stayed moved, that's weird. Whoa! Alright, looks like we're making some progress here. Alright, there's a key. Well, I guess in a sense, this is a multi-room puzzle because we did need to get the key from over here. It's just not multi-room in the sense that some of the stuff resets. Maybe it won't all reset. I don't know. The wheel didn't reset. Let's see. Are we going to be in another cave or are we going to be cruising towards Nightingale? Oh, stretch that trunk. You know, it's been a long day of hooting and hollering. More hedgehogs. So many hedgehogs. This way to Nightingale. Oh gosh, Ingrid was here. But we're making our way closer and closer to Nightingale. Grabbing currency. Oh, a knight.
Hey!
Hi, this is Nightingale. Word of your arrival spread, Elephant Queen Cynthari. I wish to see you. Please proceed.
Alright, I just want to see what this environment looks like, and we'll wrap things up. So yeah, Yono and the Celestial Elephants out Thursday on the eShop. $15. Neckbolt Games. And here you have another nice city full of monks, mystical people, weird people, and probably some more puzzles and elephant worship. If you guys enjoyed, let me know in the comments down below what you think of Yono. Are you planning on picking it up, or does it look like a pass for you? There's a lot of stuff coming to eShop lately, so you'll have to be vigilant, but I want to give you the best quick look I possibly could, and hopefully the last 30 minutes or so gave you an idea if this is the right game for you. Until next time, everybody, have a fantastic day. Thanks so much for watching. Switch Force out.